Now we are going to discuss that how to visualize the data by using R programming. So R is a pure graphical representation programming language, right? It is a purely statistical analysis and graphical representation programming language. For doing the data visualizations, no need to go to any other, no need to use any other third party tools like a Tableau, so and so, right? So whatever the data visualization that we have to do, everything that we can do in the R programming language, right? So whatever the features that we are having in the Power BI, Tableau and so reporting tools, all these features that we are having in this R programming language, in this course that we are going to discuss that how to do the graphical representations, that it is how to visualize the data by using R programming. We are having powerful libraries in this R programming language. So let us observe that what are the contents that we are going to discuss, what are the topics that we are going to cover here, right? Data visualization using Python or programming. So with so many functions like a pie chart, 3D visualizations also that we can do by using this R programming, right? So 3D pie charts, bar charts, box plot, histograms, scatter plots, low level plotting, high level plotting, right? How to combine the plots, how to add additional features to the existing plots. So these are all the things that we are going to discuss with the statistical concepts. See, let us observe.
Last session, we discussed about some of the statistical functions we create by using a credit data set. We done some of the analysis, just simply observing the range, mean, median, and then check the box plot, how the data is distributed. All right, next, we loaded the used cars data set. By using this used cars data set, we check the quantiles. Quantiles it produces 0, 25, 50, 75, 100 percentile, right? If you want as per our requirement, then we have to, mention the sequence function in this quantile, right? As per our requirement, it is going to give the quantile data. Next, we observe a summary and by using some of the plots. Next, we observe some of the statistical observations. There is statistical functions, that is interquantile ratio, interquantile range, that is IQR, variance, standard deviation. By using these functions, we observe some of the statistical values, how to check the interquantile ratio, actually what is this interquantile ratio, how this range is calculated, from which quantile to which quantile it is calculated. Next, we observe the variance. Variance means, the difference from, each value to the average value, right? And we observe the standard deviation. These are some of the functions that we observe, and we check the distribution also, how the data is distributed, whether it distributed in the left side or right side, or equally it is distributed, right? These are the examples that we observe. Now, in this session, we are going to discuss about that is graphical representation, that is data visualization, right? Data visualization also called as plot. See, after doing analysis, that analysis that we have to done in a graphical representation, then only, our clients can understand their business statistics. Why? Because whatever that analysis that we done, if you give the documents directly, they are not in a position to understand the business statistics. So that's why we are going to convert that data into a graphical representation that is called data visualization, right? And then they will understand. Now, in this data visualization here, we can do in two different plottings. In that, first one is a high level plotting. High level plotting means, okay, it generates a new plots. Next, low level plotting. Low level plotting means editing the existing plot. Right? Whatever the plots that we created newly, those are all comes under high level plotting. Whatever the editing that we done on the existing plots, those are comes under the low level plotting. In our programming language, we are having so many libraries to create the charts and graphs, right? In our programming language, we are having so many libraries. That is, libraries means the packages with functions, right? So many functions that we are having to create the charts and graphs. Data can be visualized, okay, in the form of so many graphs and charts. Okay, let us discuss what are those. Our programming language, right, has many libraries to create charts and graphs. Data can be visualized in the form of, okay, we are having some of the graphs, okay, charts that we are having. This data can be visualized, okay, based on these formats. We're having pie charts, okay, in pie charts format, we can visualize like this. We are having bar charts, box plots, right? Histograms, line graphs, scatter plots. Okay, these are all the different charts, okay, different graphs that we are having. We can visualize the data by using these formats. Now, let us discuss one by one, okay, what is this chart, how we are going to represent, what is the syntax that we are having, what are the arguments that it contains in the syntax, how to create the, okay, charts. Now, let us discuss about pie charts. This pie chart is a representation of values as slices as a circle. Okay, pie means already we know. Okay, pie means what? It is in a circle, in the format of circle. Okay, here in this circle, it contains some of the slices. Okay, based on these slices, it is going to divide like this. For example, it is, okay, some percentage of the data is distributed like this. Some is like this. Okay, like this. For example, okay, if you take this is approximately, it is a 45%, right? Next, it is 25%. Next, it is 35%. Right? Like this, okay? Like the pie charts will be represented. Yes? Now, let us observe, a pie chart is a representation of values as slices of a circle with the different colors. Yes. Next, these slices are labeled and the numbers corresponding to each slice is also represented in the chart. See, this pie chart is created by using one of the function. Okay, that function is a pie chart, pie function. All right. This pie function takes the numerical values, that is positive numbers, it will take as a vector input. And this pie chart is pie is having some of the arguments that we are having. If you want to control the labels or if you want to control the color, title, etc. Like this, we are having some of the arguments. Based on those arguments, we can create the charts, pie charts as per our requirement. Yes. Let us discuss a syntax of this pie chart. Okay, what is the function? Pie is the function. Here we have to give some numerical values, the two positive numerical values. Based on these positive numerical values, right, it will create the pie chart. If you want to give any arguments, like if you want to give some description to the slices, then we have to use one argument that is called labels. What is that argument? Labels. Like this, we are having some of the arguments are radius, okay, main, color, clockwise. This is the syntax, right? Now let us discuss one by one. This x is a vector containing the numerical values used in the pie chart. Yes, if you want to describe, if you want to give some description to the slices, then we have to use the labels, right? It is used to give description to the slices. Next, radius. Okay, if you want to mention that how much radius that if you want to give, right, this value is in between minus 1 to plus 1 only, right? In between minus 1 and plus 1, okay, we have to give the radius range, okay, radius of the circle. Next, if you want to give the title of the chart, then we have to use this argument that is called main. Okay, this main indicates the title of the chart. If you want to fill the colors, okay, if you want fill with some colors, then we have to use one argument that is called COL. This COL argument is used to, okay, to fill the colors. Next, okay, actually in a pie chart, okay, for example, if you take, this is the pie chart, whatever the data that we are having, okay, the data will be in the format of, by default, it is in the format of clockwise. For example, say if you take in our data, it contains three parts. First part, this is the first part. For example, this slice is first part. Next slice moves in a, okay, clockwise, all right? In a clockwise direction, it will drop. See, here, if you don't want in this clockwise direction, right, then if you require in this direction, then we have to use this clockwise argument. It is a logical value, right? By default, it is true. That's why it is going to fill in this direction, right? If you want in this opposite direction, then we have to set that clockwise equals to false. Okay, that means, it will drawn in a anti-clockwise format. Getting my point? These are the arguments that we are having. Now let us discuss one by one, okay, how to use this pie chart and how to use these arguments. Now I am drawing one of the simple pie chart by using some of input vector, right? See, most of the functions, okay, for doing data visualization, most of the functions are belongs to the, okay, base, some of the packages. Just check it. Search, by default, we are having 9 packages in our R environment. In these 9 packages, okay, most of the data visualization functions are belongs to the base package, right? Base is the package, right? In this base package, we are having some of the functions. Graphics is there, right? Graphics is one of the package for doing the data visualization. Next, GR devices, okay, graphical devices. In this package also, we are having so many functions which belongs to the plotting. For doing plotting, we are having this package. Most of the functions are belongs to this graphics and graphic devices packages. Yes. Now, whatever the plottings that we are created, okay, all these plots are going to create and save in our current working directory, right? What is our current working directory? Already in the last session that we discussed how to check the current working directory, how to set the current working directory. Okay, this documents is the current working directory, right? This documents is the current working directory. Present we are in this directory, it doesn't contains any charts. Whatever the charts that we are create, okay, those charts are going to save by default in this current working directory. Yes, now I'm taking some one of the simple vector. Based on this vector, okay, we will understand the concept. Later we'll take the real-time data sets, okay, whatever the data sets that we worked in the previous sessions, like user cards, some of the credit data set, okay, like that. Based on some real-time data sets, we will work on the data visualization. Yes, now I'm creating one of the vector based on this vector, right? We will do some graphical representation. Right, x is having so and so values, 21 62 10 53, and then I'm taking one more vector, right? In this vector I'm assigning some of the names. City names I'm taking. City names, and these are the x is the sales in each city. Okay, this, okay, this is the city names and these are the sales. Okay, let us take any one of the dummy. Next step. Labels, it contains some of the city names. Now, okay, see, before creating a chart, okay, what will happen in the last session, we observe some of the statistical values, okay, statistical observations in a histogram we observe, in plot, a box plot we observe, okay, some of the ranges that we observe in a, okay, plottings by using box plot and histograms. Whatever the chart that we created, the chart automatically executed in this R itself. Okay, it is not storing in our system, right? If you want to store that chart, okay, whatever the chart that we are creating, present we are working on the pie chart, right? If you want to store this pie chart in our system, okay, first we have to give the file name by using one function. That function is called png. What is that function? That function is called png. This png function, okay, is used to give the graphic device, okay, graphics in some of the formats like JPEG format, png format, TIFF format, like that we are having, okay, some of the formats that we are having, okay, to save the pictorial representation is stored in some of the formats. These are the formats: JPEG, okay, PNG, BMP, TIFF formats, like that we are having some of the formats. All these formats are going to store in our system by using one function. That function is called png. Here we have to give the file name. File equals to city.jpg. File equals to some, I'm giving the file name, it is a city. See, here in this png we are not giving any path, okay, we are not giving any path like c so and so path. By default it is going to store in our current working directory. This is the current working directory that we are having. In this current working directory it is going to store. Now I'm executing this. Once observe here, yes, it is executed successfully. The file name, what is the file name? City JPG means in the format of JPEG format. It is stored in the current working directory. See, present. Now one file is created, city, okay, JPEG image is created. If you observe here, city, okay, JPEG image file is created. But in this file it doesn't contain any data. If you want, open it. See, I'm opening. See, it doesn't contains any image. Why? Because just we created a file, okay, just we created a JPEG file, okay, without any data. Now okay, in this file I am going to create some data giving some values by using some function. What is that function? Pie function. Pie means it is a pie chart. By using this x and y, by using this x and labels, okay, vectors, I am taking x comma labels, x comma labels. Now let us observe. Now I am executing this. It is executed successfully without any errors. Okay, I created a pie chart for this x and labels. It will, how it is going to represent means, it is going to represent like this. 21, okay, first value is 21. For this 21, it will take some slice, like for example, okay, this is the 21. For this 21, it will give the label. Okay, what is the first label that we are having? London. Here it will produce London. Next it is 62, like this. It is 62. Some, what is the label that it is? It is New York. Like this, it will be represented. Okay, once check it. See, even though it is not executed, even though it is not okay updated. Why? Because okay, here after plotting the chart, then we have to save that file. Whenever if you save that file, then only it is going to save update in our file. Getting my point? For that, we have to use one function. That function is called dev.off. Device off. Okay, here we started by using this png. Here we started the device and we written some script, that we written some code. After that we have to stop the device, then only it is going to save in the file. The function is dev.off device.off. This function provides a control over multiple graphic devices, right? Here it is going to save. Now I am executing this dev.off. Now one device is created. Null device one. Yes. Once go to the current working directory. Okay. If you observe here, previous it is 0 KB. Now it is 4 KB. Now it is 4 KB. Means some data is filled in that file. Now let us open that file. Right. This is the city file name. It contains like, okay, this is the data that we are having. London, New York, Singapore, Mumbai. By default, it is filled in a anti-clockwise. Okay. Why? Because I think by default it is a logical value is false. If you want in a clockwise, then we have to set true. Clockwise equals to true. Then it is going to fill in this direction. London, New York, like this. Okay. Clockwise means right side, anti-clockwise means left side. I think by default it is in, okay, clockwise is false, so it is filled in this direction by taking some of the colors. Okay, by itself it is taking some colors, we are not producing any colors. Okay, by it is taking some of the light colors and then it is filled like this. Okay, we have to create the pie charts like this. We have to create the pie charts. Now let us observe how to give the titles for the pie chart. Okay, present in this diagram, it doesn't contain any title, right? See, any title, it doesn't contain. It contains only the labels for the, okay, each slice. Yes. Now let us discuss some of the manipulations. Okay, adding some features, expand the features for this chart, right? Now let's discuss about pie chart title and colors, how to expand the pie title and colors in our chart. See, we can expand the features of the charts by adding some of the arguments. Whatever the arguments that we are having, labels, okay, already we use these labels, right? X is the data we given. In these labels, okay, we given some of the names of each slice. Next, we are having some of the arguments like radius, main, color, clockwise. By using these arguments, okay, we can add the, we can expand the features of the chart. Now I'm going to use this main argument, okay, for adding some title, and one more argument, that is color. COL is one of the argument. Okay, here I'm using this color in our chart. Now let us observe. Okay, I'm creating one more. For that, I'm creating one more file name. Already we created city. Okay, now I'm going to create one more file name. If you want to create another file, then we have to use png file equals to, file equals to whatever the file name that you want mention here. Yes, png file equals to file name. Now execute it. One file is created, empty file is created with 0 KB. So city title colors, a file is created with 0 KB. After after that, then we have to create the function. After creating the function, then save that file by using a function dev, that is device.off, then it is going to store in our system. Getting my point? Now plot the chart with the title and rainbow color palette. Okay, I'm giving up a rainbow color for it. Why? Because rainbow is having multiple colors. All those multiple colors are going to, okay, set for these values. Whatever the values that we are having in our X, those values it will be set. Now let us observe how to work with this pie. Pie. Here we have to use some of the arguments. What are the arguments that we have to use means? Yes. Now let us observe. What are the arguments that we have to use means? First, we have to give the input vector, where the vector is available. What is the name of the vector that we are having? X. In X it contains, if you want mention the labels. Next, if you want to give the title for this chart, then we have to use the main. What is the argument? Main argument. Okay, here we have to mention city, pie, chart, some name I'm giving. Next. Okay, then if you want to give color equals to if I give blue like this, blue, what will happen? All the slices will fill with blue color only. All the slices will fill blue color only. Otherwise, I want to fill the slices like this, okay, one by one. Then I have to mention some of the colors like blue, green, okay. How many slices that you want to fill with colors, mention that colors in C. Otherwise, rainbow is one of the color that we are having. Why? Because in rainbow we are having some multiple colors. Those multiple colors are going to fill in our chart slice by slice, right? Further, directly I am giving rainbow. Then we have to mention the length, how much color that it is going to fill means. It's depend on the, okay, the value of each element. Getting my point? For example, rainbow, we given rainbow. Okay, how much color it is we have to fill? For example, 21 is there. Okay, out of this 21, how much color that it is going to fill means. Here we have to mention the length of this X. Whenever if you mention the length of this X, okay, based on the length of this value, that is 21, 62, okay, based on this length, it is going to fill the rainbow colors. Getting my point? Here we have to mention the length of X. Okay, then close the pie function. Yes. Object labels, okay, BELS, I think it is. We created LABELS. Labels. Length of X. Yes. This is the function. X, okay, this is the function. It is executed successfully. Whatever the whatever the chart that we created, right, with the title and rainbow color, that we have to store in our system. How to save it? By using device.div.off. Once if you use this div.off, then it is going to store whatever that that we done, everything that is stored in this file. What is the file name? City underscore title underscore colors, in which format? In JPEG format, executed. DEV, it's not device, DEV, right? Yes. Now it is executed. Once go to the current working directory, check it. Now it is filled with 4KB, right? Observe here. This is the title. By using main argument, we return this title, that is, okay, so and so some city pie chart. And we filled, okay, all these slices with the rainbow colors, and then we mentioned that length of X, right? It is going to fill the complete slice. Each color is filled the complete slice. Like this, okay, we have to work with these pie charts by giving some titles and colors. Now let us observe, see, this is some of the sales that we are having. This is the 21 sales in this city. Here, the label we mentioned that it is London. Now I don't want these label names, okay? I want the percentage. Out of these sales, right? I want the percentage, that is probability of this London. Just I want in the place of city name, just I want, for example, it is out of all these, it is going to calculate, right? Out of 100, for example, it is a 20%. Now I want to mention like this 20% here, it is 61. Actually the sales is 61. Out of this total, if it is 61, then I want the sum, not some probability, that is percentile I want. Okay. And I want some of the charts also. See, if I, in the place of these city names, if I mention percentage like 20%, 60% like this, right? Then how to know that this green is belongs to the New York and this red is belongs to London, this blue is belongs to Mumbai? Then we have to create one of the legend means what? Okay. Whenever if you observe some of the JPEG files or reporting files, right, in the top, anyway, maybe it may be in the top right or top left, or it may be bottom left or bottom right, we're having some legend chart here. It will indicate that, okay, for example, one green box, it will display one green box. Okay, beside this green box, they mentioned that it is New York, and again they mention some red box. In this red box, okay, beside this red box, they mention this is London. Like this, we have to understand. This is called a legend. Okay, that we can mention anywhere in the chart. Okay, you can mention in the top right, we can mention top left, we can mention in the bottoms left or right, we can mention. As per our requirement, we can mention anyway. This is called a legend. What it is? It is legend. For that, we are having one function. That function is legend only. By using this legend function, okay, we can give the names for it. Right? Now let us observe how to work on this. Now, okay, I'm creating one of the chart. In this chart, okay, as per our requirement, I want to add the slice percentage, and I want to add a legend by creating additional chart variables. Getting my point? If you want to calculate into, just observe what is the X values that we are having. These are the X values. If you want to convert into the probability, how to convert these values into probability? Okay, first 21 by sum of all these into 100. Getting my point? Into 100. Like this, we have to calculate. For example, if I want to convert this probability 21 by sum of all these, approximately, okay, not just I am taking sum of all these values x into 100, right? Like this, we have to calculate the percentile. For example, the same thing if I write like this, okay, x, okay, for example, x by sum of x into 100. But if the system will take like this, okay, x is separate and the sum of this will be separate, x into sum of into 100, and it will be calculated different way, right? It is better to take like this, x into 100 by sum of x. Then it is going to calculate the percentile for each element. First element of x, second element, third element, fourth element. And the percentile, okay, should be in like this, with the decimals, like, for example, 20.56. Out of 100, it will be calculated into probability. That is like this, with some decimals, okay? With decimals, it will give the percentile, 20.56 for some, like that. If you want to round it, okay, why? Because it is better to round, okay, then it will be 21% like that. Then use one function, that function is called round. Already we discussed all these, okay, round, everything, how to calculate the percentile, okay. Now, let us observe. I'm creating, okay, percentiles, 100 into x, right? By sum of x. Now I am going to round 1. Yes, next this I am assigning one of the variable pi percent, right? In this pi percent, it contains the percentile. One check the pi percent, what it contains. It is 14.4, 42.5, okay, 14.4 something is there, right? Here we use one function, round function, okay, with one decimal. So it will be, it is taking only 14.4. See, some of the value without round, what will happen means, yes, now let us observe without round. These are the values, 14.383562 is the percentile for the first element. Whenever you use round comma 1, okay, after that it will 3.84, everything it is going to take it into a single. 3.38 means it will convert it into 4, like that. Next, okay, you understood this, how to calculate this pi percentile. Okay, we calculated the pi percentile. Now create the function pi. Before writing this, before creating a chart, first create one file name, okay? Give the chart file name by using png file equals to, here I am giving a city, this is percentile, right? Percentage legends dot JPEG format. City percentile legends. Yes. Now one file is created with the city percentile legends in our current working directory. Yes, it is created. Now I am creating the chart pi on x labels. See, here I am giving labels, okay, not these city names, right? Here I am giving the labels pi percentage I am giving. Whatever the percentage is that I created, okay, I am giving the pi percentage. Next, title name for this chart, city pie chart. Color, I am giving a rainbow. Rainbow length of x, I am mentioning. Close the bracket. Execute. Yes, it is successfully completed without any errors, right? Just now we created one of the pie chart. Okay, it is represent like this. Once observe is like this, it is going to represent. Next, the slices are divided like this. First slice, it is first. Okay, first slice. Okay, it will be calculated like this. Whatever the 21 that we are having, the place of label, name of the label here, okay, it will mention the percentile. What are the percentile that we are having for the 21? For example, 14.4. Like this, it will mention. Why? Because here we mentioned that labels equals to pi percent. Whatever the percentages that we are having in this 5%, that percentages, it is display here. Next one. Okay, so and so percentile. Next, city pie chart, color equals to rainbow. Okay, up to now, okay, we design like this. Next, what is our requirement? Then we have to create the lesson, right? For understanding what is this green color percentile, what is this red color percentile, okay, which state it belongs, okay, like that. If you want to understand, then we have to create one legend. That legend may be in anyway, okay, in the four edges, anywhere we can create. In this box, it is going to represent what green color, which city it is, red, which city it is, like that. Yes. Now, for that, we have to use one function. That function is called legend, L-E-G-E-N-D, right? This legend is used to add the, this legend function is used to add the legends to plots. This legend function is used to add legends to plots. Yes. Yes. Legend of where we have to present it. Okay. Now I want to present in the top right. We have to mention like this. If you want top right, top right. If you want top left, okay. Bottom right, bottom left, like this we have to mention. Next, what are the city names that, okay, it is having, that we have to mention. For the first percentile, in this 5%, okay, we are having some percentiles, that city names that we have to mention here. First, for example, first percentile is belongs to, first sales percentile is belong to London, like this we have to mention. Here we are. Next, we have to mention the CEX. Okay, it is going to use the CEX. It is. These are the arguments that we are having. Just mention any some value. Based on that value only, it is going to, okay, create. Next, whatever the colors that you want to fill. Why? Because once I will show you, that legend will be displayed like this. In this legend, okay, here a small boxes is there. Remember, small boxes. Okay, this is the size for this. Okay, CEX. If you want to mention in large, then increase that. Right. Next, colors we have to mention. See here, top right, it will be displayed at the top right. Next, some of the labels that we are giving. First one, it is London. Here it will be printed London. Next, for the next one, it will be printed New York, like this. And colors also here we need to fill, right? That colors, okay, we have to use, for that we have to use this argument, fill equals to a rainbow. Fill is rainbow of length x. Close the legend function also. Yes, somewhere error. It is length. Yes. Now it is executed. See, pie chart we created, that is also executed successfully. After that, okay, next we created the legend on this pie chart. On that pie chart, okay, at the top right, we created with these labels, and these labels is filled by colors, right? Now, if you want to store, okay, then we have to use save this file by using one function that is called dev.off. Yes, it is saved successfully. Once go to your current working directory, this is the file that we created, city percentage legends. Check it. This is the title and these are the percentages. Okay, and these are the colors by using COL, and we created a legend like this. Yes, in this this legend that we represented in the top right, that's why here it is displayed. If you mention top left, then here it will be displayed. Next, CEX that we mentioned, right, 1.0, some value we have to give, how much size that if you want. And then we mentioned the some of the labels, okay, London, New York, everything. And we fill some of colors, right? These, whatever the colors that we filled here, the same colors here also we fill. Here we mentioned that this red is London. Whatever the green that we are having, this is New York. The blue, it is Mumbai. And light blue, it is sky blue, it is Singapore. Yes, like this. Okay, we have to create the pie charts. Next, if you want to do advanced, okay, charts, okay, advanced in a more graphical representation, right? See, whatever the functions that we are having in our base package, whatever the functions that we are having in a graphics package, right? And GR devices is the package, right? Most of the packages, okay, most of the functions we can do the data visualization. But whenever if you want the advanced graphical representation, right? Advanced means what? Okay, whatever the charts that we created present, these charts are 2D charts, two dimension charts. Advanced means that is in 3D, okay, three dimensional, okay, charts. For that, we have to use one of the package. Okay, in that package, it contains okay, advanced functions. Based on that functions, we can create the 3D charts, right? Now let us discuss about 3D pie charts. Ready means a pie chart with three dimensions, okay, can be drawn using additional package that we have to use some additional package. The package name is PlotRigs. What is the package name? PlotRigs is the package. In this package, you are having so many advanced functions. In this package, we are having one of the function. That function is Pi3D. What is the function? Pi3D is the function. By using this Pi3D function, we can create the 3D pie charts. Yes, first load the package in our R environment. How to load it? Install.packages. What is the package name? PlotRigs is the package name, right? Just load it into in our R environment. Yes, it is downloaded successfully. It is downloaded from CRAN. Okay, it's only 1 MB space it we require. It is successfully downloaded in our system. Just load it. How to load it? Library or required. Now it is loaded. One check it. Previous it is 9. Now it is 10. This PlotRigs is added in our R environment. Yes. Now let us create one of the 3D pie chart, okay, by using one of the function. What is the function that we are having? Pi 3D is the function which belongs to, okay, plot rx package. First, I'm giving the file name, file equals to 3D pie chart dot jpeg. Whatever the format, okay, if you want in PNG format or TIFF format, GIF format, okay, here we have to mention the, in this extension, we have to give it. If you want PNG format, okay, PNG, BNG is there format, right? TIFF format is there, okay, whatever the format, okay, just give the extension here. Now, I'm executing. The file is created, 3D pie is created here. Once observed, 3D pie chart is created. Now I am plotting the chart pi, what is the function? Pi 3D x comma labels directly I am giving labels here. We are having some of the arguments, explore 0.1. What is the use of this arguments means explore. I will show you after executing. If you want to give the title, then we have to use main. Pie charts in 3D I'm giving. Yes. Okay, LVL is not there actually. If you want percentile, just give the pi percentile here. Otherwise, if you want labels, direct labels, okay, we created one of the vector. In that vector, we stored that vector is labels. Getting my point? Executing. Yes, it is executed successfully. Okay, in labels we created some of the values, some of the city names like London, New York, everything, right? That's why I'm giving here labels. Yes, it is created successfully. Next, save it. Yes, it is saved. Once go to this 3D pie chart, once observe this. Like this, it is created. Okay, this is the 3D pie chart. We use some one of the argument that is explode some value, right? 0.1 I given. That explode is this. How much explode that you give? Okay, 0.1 means it is a 10%. Here 10%, okay, it is divided in a graphical way. Why? Because if you give 1%, 2%, there we can't find this separation. Right, that way I given a 10%. If you mention 0.2, then it is 20%, right? Then it will the distance is more, one slice to another slice. Like this, we have to work with the pie charts and 3D pie charts, and then we have to work with some arguments, right? Next, let us discuss about bar charts. Bar charts. Right, we know pie charts, okay, how to create pie charts, how to work with the pie charts, right? Bar charts, okay, bar charts means it is how it is going to represent. Once if you want check it, right, these are the pie charts. Okay, these are all the pie charts. if you want with the legends. Okay, observe here. This is the pie chart with the legends like this we have to create. Next, let us observe a bar charts. Okay, bar charts are created like this. This is the horizontal and vertical like this we have to create. This is the simple bar chart. Okay, a bar chart represents the data in rectangular bars, okay, with the length of the bar. Based on the proportional, okay, it is going to calculate. Proportional means the percentile, okay. For example, this is the 2011 data. In this 2011, okay, the data is like this, okay. Sum of which belongs to, these are the three different data that we are having in this 2011. The blue data is in this range, okay, up to here. The orange is up to here. Some other color is up to here. Like this, it is going to represent, right? Now, let us observe. A bar chart represents data in rectangular bars. Data in rectangular bars with the length of the proportional value of the variable. For this, we have to use one function. That function is bar plot function, right? To create the bar charts. What is the function? Bar plot. By using this function, we can create the bar charts. This can be created in vertical or horizontal. Okay, just now we observe some of the charts are created in vertical, some of the charts are created in horizontal. Okay, for that we in this bar we are having not only in that different features that we can add, like some of the colors, okay, titles, names, everything that we have to work. Now let us discuss, let us observe the syntax, then we will get the clarity. Okay, what are the arguments that we are having? What is the function? Bar plot is the function. In this bar plot, first we have to give the vector, not only vector. Actually, in the pie chart, we have to give only vector, but here we can give the matrix also, but the two in numerical values only, right? Here we can give a vector or a matrix. Next, if you want to give the labels for the x-axis, right? Next, that for that we are having xlab. Next, if you want to give the labels for the y-axis, then we have to use ylab, right? If you want to give the title for this bar chart, then we have to use main. Next, if you want give the names, okay, for each bar, getting my point? This title, this main is for title for the complete bar plot. Each bar is there, right? In the complete bar plot, okay, each bar is there in a rectangular. If you want to give the name for each bar, then we have to use one argument that is called names.org. Argument, ARG. Names.org. Here we have to mention, okay, whatever the names that you want to appear under each bar. Then if you want to fill with some colors, okay, then we have to use col, C-O-L. It is used to give colors to the bars in the graphs. Right, these are the arguments that we are having. Next, okay, let us take some of the example and then we will create the bar plots. Right, like that we have to work with these bar plots. Right, in this session we discussed about data visualization, that is plotting. Okay, here we can do in two different plottings. One is high level plotting and low level plotting. Whatever the plots that we created newly, those are comes under high level. Whatever that we edit for the existing plot, those are comes under low level. For that, we are having so many packages, okay, to create the charts and graphs. Okay, we can visualize in different formats like pie charts, bar charts, box plot, histograms, line graphs, scatter plots. Like this, we are having different charts. Okay, different formats that we are having. Today we discussed about pie charts, and next class we will discuss the remaining charts, that is bar chart, box plots, everything. After discussing this, in this session and tomorrow session, okay, we will discuss with some dummy data. Dummy data means just we created one vector. Okay, based on that vector, how to create a pie chart, how to do the editing, right? Everything that we will discuss. After understanding all these charts, then we will take the real time data, right? Based on the real time data, okay, then we will start the analysis, and then we will visualize that analysis in a graphical format, right? By using these formats that we will do in the next class. Okay, this is about today's session. Any more queries? Right, tomorrow we'll